I found at this age I was starting to know some signs of lines around my mouth and tiredness around the eyes, and I thought at 45 I didn't want to do a surgical procedure. I wanted something less invasive that would give me just a more youthful appearance.
So in increasing a bit the volume of her lips, then we should get very natural results and a nice smile. We will also assess the region around the mouth where she has a bit deeper wrinkles and a loss of volume in this region. She doesn't really need anything in her cheeks. She has nice cheekbones. And for the concern about the wrinkles, crow's feet, and the region between the eyes, which we call the glabella, then it will be done with a treatment of Botox that we will show later. So I'll be working with the cannula. I can show the cannula, which is it's like a needle with the smooth tip, so it can't go through the skin, which is not traumatizing for vessels, and for the patient it's less painful also. I'm gonna make the small hole with the needle. And you can put your cannula and push over. You stay quite superficial because you're doing here the contouring. And in some cases, I can go over the lip through the other side, which is possible in our case, so that will be more easy. Andrea, it was also concerned about the lines between her eyes, the front lines, and her crow's feet. And she knows that this is best assessed with the Botox. She had some before. So she's here today to so that we can give the a demonstration on how we inject the Botox. We will have to do many little injections of Botox. And we do these injections in the muscles in order to weaken the muscles underneath that are causing the wrinkles and the crow's feet. The little swelling that we get there will disappear within 10 to 15 minutes. So when we met last time, I think that you were concerned a bit about the, because you have a very nice skin texture, very nice volume of lips, you have very few wrinkles, but concerned a bit about these folds that are the nasal labial folds. And I was explaining to you that most of the time when you get these folds, it's because you lose volume in the cheek. So the face when aging is not only sagging, but it's deflating. And if we do replace a bit of volume in the cheek, it gives a very natural result, and it sort of open a little bit the nasal labial fold. So we were going to put a bit of volume in your fold and a bit in your cheek, and then we will correct also under your eye the a bit like we did last time. Okay. You can close your eyes and just try to relax the small hole in there. You feel the same pressure, or it's going okay?
It's fine.
So it's fine now? Good. Brigitte, qui est une patiente de 44 ans, qui vient me voir aujourd'hui pour avoir des traitements là, pour avoir l'air un peu plus jeune. Elle rajeunit au niveau des joues, des tempes, où elle a perdu un peu de volume. C'est juste pour le confort de la patiente ici. Éviter aussi parfois que ça saigne un peu, le fait qu'il y ait de l'épinéphrine dans la xylocaïne.
toujours bien important de savoir où se situe l'extrémité de la canule. Aller chercher, c'est vraiment presque pas de volume au niveau antérieur parce qu'elle a quand même un peu de convexité, mais l'apex de sa joue pour lui donner là, une pommette un petit peu plus saillante, ce qui fait plus jeune.